Good evening. A family fleeing war-torn Ukraine has received a shocking welcome to Queensland, not even allowed to hug their Aussie relatives.
Instead, they were immediately forced into quarantine because they're unvaccinated. Tonight, they're pleading with authorities to show some mercy.
Happy, smiling, enjoying family time in the backyard of their Brisbane home. It's a far cry from the Ukraine capital of Kyiv, where the Russians are shelling, killing innocent people almost daily.
It's just so hard.
Irina Billick and her husband Martin Cropper live here in Queensland, but their family live in Kyiv. Just over a week ago, though, Irina's mother, her sister-in-law and niece managed to flee.
They were panicking, there were tears, you know, we've got a little girl who's 7 years old, she didn't know where the bombs were coming from.
But Irina's mother had to make the heartbreaking decision to leave her two sons, her son-in-law and her husband behind.
Just a big hug. She prayed for them. Sorry. That she loves them, like any mother would.
The three escaped to Romania and were greeted by Martin. They were now free of the war, but never did they imagine they were about to enter a battle. They speak little English. Their passports were expired. However, Martin managed to get them to Brisbane, but that's when he says things turned ugly. The family was separated because they haven't had their COVID vaccines.
After all I'd been through, to get to that point and realise that they were going to be taken away.
Martin and Irina say customs officers refused to let them embrace.
They were not allowed to come anywhere near each other, and then they took her away.
The three refugees were then put on a bus and sent to well camp and told that's where they would have to isolate for the next fortnight.
My niece actually believes she's been captured by the Russians.
Both Martin and Irina said the treatment their family endured while being at well camp has been atrocious, even claiming that on the first night they arrived, they were denied food because it was too late and were not able to wash the little amount of clothing that they had for at least 2 days. So I asked Irina's mother what she thought.
Would you be able to ask your mother how she feels she's been treated since she arrived here in Australia?
She feels they've been humiliated and that nobody cared, and the little granddaughter said that she felt that they'd been taken to prison.
Well, Peter Fegan joins us now in the studio. Peter, you have an update on the family situation.
I do, Melissa. Well, it's important to note that the family was given an exemption by the federal government to travel here, but it was the state government's policy that put them into quarantine. But common sense has since prevailed. Irina and Martin have been informed that their family will be allowed to do the remainder of their quarantine period at home, but they are still waiting for more information on that to happen. It will be very interesting to see when they do get home.
How quickly it happens. Mm.